Hi, gang. Welcome to Man of the Street. I'm your host, Justin Case. Where we come to your friends and neighbors in the community, and we ask them the question of the day. Let's see who we have first up today from the producers. Who do we have there? Hello. Hey, it's Mailman Bill. How are you?
I'm taking a break.
Well, what's the matter, Bill? What's going on?
The Postal Service is a mess right now.
Well, it kind of is, yeah. And that's it? It's a mess, and so you're taking an extra long break?
Well, I mean, Amazon's already delivered like 5 packages to this person's house, so I figured I'd have a seat and give it a minute.
Oh, you're just hanging out at somebody's house right over here.
I mean, it's a comfy couch. I might as well take a load off.
You know, if I was there, I'd be there with you. Hey, let me ask you our question of the day, Bill, if you don't mind. If you were the president, what's the first thing you would do to help the country?
You know, I definitely wouldn't privatize the USPS.
Well,
we're a national pastime.
No, very much so. That's baseball. We love that. But what would you change?
I think I would decrease pricing. That making mailing so much easier. I mean, the big guys, the big private companies, they don't take true care of their packages like we do.
All right. I'm sorry things are going bad, but maybe if you knock nice on the door, they'll get you a lemonade in that place over there, Bill. That might be an idea. And make you feel better.
I might have to.
All right.
Good idea.
Well, thanks for coming, Bill. We appreciate you stopping by, as always.
Thank you, Justin.
You're welcome. And let's see who the producers have up next for us. Let's see where there goes Bill. And we have, it looks like you're at the airport, sir. What is your name?
Hello, Jack Johnson. Not the singer.
No, not the singer. How are you, Jack?
I'm stressed. I've been trapped in this airport for about 2.5 months now, thanks COVID.
Which airport are you at?
Oh, I mean the Columbus International Airport. I flew in here because I was taking advantage of the good prices, hey? Right? There's lots of free flights. Why don't you take a holiday to the U.S., huh? And enjoy the great Midwest. No, now I'm stuck here. Can't find my way home.
Well, you know, Columbus is an interesting place to be stuck in the airport especially. But what do you do in Australia, Jack?
Oh, in Australia, it's my running joke. I'm not Jack Johnson, the singer, but I do work with pipes. I'm a plumber.
Of your power, very good. Well, maybe this question will help. Have you spent a little time in America aside from just this trip?
Well, that's the problem. I only had enough money to stay here for a week. I've been living in the airport for the last 2.5 months. These little bottles won't last so long.
I can imagine. This question might be easy for you then. If you were the president of the United States, what would you change about the world right now?
Oh, what I'd change if I were that guy. Well, first thing I'd do is I'd leave. Tell you what, the president they've got going on right now, he needs to get out. That's what I do. But if I were the president, first thing I'd do is I'd let all Australians go back home. He's talking about sending all the immigrants out. No, let's take all the people on holiday. Let them go home. I can't fly home right now.
No, you know what? But you might find something exciting to do in Columbus. You know, maybe there's a custard place you could go visit. I don't know. I'm just hang in there, Jack. We'll send some food down to you that's not airport related. How's that?
Oh, that sounds absolutely great. I'd love that.
My pleasure. Well, thanks for stopping by, Jack. We appreciate it. Poor fella. I hope he gets home. Who do we have next there, producers? Who's coming on now? I know there's somebody. I can do
Yo!
That. What? That scared me. Wait, madam, who are you?
My name is Daisy Jones.
Daisy Jones. Any relation to, the singer of the
band?
No. None at all. You seem to be in, shall we say, pirate's garb?
Oh, sure. I find myself a modern-day pirate.
You're a modern-day pirate. And, and what port do you work out of?
Carmel, Indiana.
I didn't know they had a lot of ports up in Carmel.
Aye, we do. We have the Morse Reservoir and Geist. They're all nearby.
So you're on the reservoir taking your boat around? Is that what's going on?
Aye, yes.
And then speaking of aye, how did you lose your eye?
It was a freak accident when I used to be in software sales.
Okay, I don't think I want to know any more about that. So our question for today, Daisy, if I may call you that, is if you were president of the United States, what would you do to help all the people?
I think first I'd make it legal to plunder. I love
Daisy, I don't plunder. Know if in the country it's fairly legal to plunder right now. So, you know, maybe what else perhaps?
I'd probably make rum our national treasure.
Oh, there you go. Can you sing us a song about rum?
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a bottle of rum.
You know,
if you drink enough, you'll fall on your bum.
Oh, well, that was fabulous. Well, Daisy, please stay in the neighborhood and come by.
Absolutely.
And good luck with the reservoir up in Carmel. I
thank you.
Works out for you. All right, take care. Thank you very much. Pirate, that's just fantastic. I love the producers. We had a pirate on the show. So who do we have next there, guys? Fido! How are you? For those who've never seen the show before, this is the neighborhood dog, Fido. How's it going, boy? How you doing?
I'm doing so good. I'm such a good boy.
You seem to be inside. Where's Miss Abby?
Oh, my owner, Miss Abby, she has gone somewhere in that magical box that has wheels, and I'm sure she will be back any moment.
Oh, okay, and then do you know how long you've been in there?
It's at least 5-6 minutes, hours, days, hard to say.
Okay, and do you have your ball with you? I just want to make sure everything.
I always have my ball.
I was right. I was worried, and now I know that you're happy and. It's yours. Yeah, this is good. A good boy. Who's a good boy? Come on.
I'm a good boy.
Yes, you are. All right. Well, then listen, Fido, let me ask you a question then.
Yeah.
If you were president of the United States, what would you do to help humans and dogs?
First, I would make sure that everybody got mandatory treats, because treats should be something everyone gets. And then also, I would make mandatory walks, because everyone should go on walks. And the third thing I would do is probably reform the tax system, because Abby always complains that it's not very good.
Abby's like that. She's very math-oriented.
Yeah.
Well, listen, Fido, why don't you throw the ball and go chase it, and we'll come back soon. All right? Be a good boy and bring it back, and maybe they'll give you a treat.
Oh, boy.
Okay. All right. Bye, Fido. He's a neighborhood dog. I hope he comes back again soon. Aunt Shirley, how are you? Well, now I know exactly how you are, Aunt Shirley. How are you doing, darling?
Oh, I'm good. How about you?
I'm doing terrific. Aunt Shirley lives in the neighborhood here. How long have you lived in this neighborhood, Aunt Shirley?
I've been here for over 45 years.
45 years. You must have seen a lot of changes.
Oh, I have gentrification, revolution, evolution, all kinds of strange things.
That almost sounds like a lyric. And is this your favorite shopping mall here behind you?
Oh, well, I have a little side gig. You know, I'm a retiree, so I have to supplement my income, and this is one of the ways that I do.
Well, what's another one of the ways you supplement your income?
Oh, I have a small bakery that I run.
Oh, you run, really? Where can I buy your baked goods?
I was on apartment 420 down the way over there at the Ashbrook.
Okay, Ashbrook. All right, very, very good. We'll talk about that another time, perhaps, on Shirley. Let me ask you a question. I know this is on a lot of people's minds, but if you were president, what would you do to change the country?
Change the country? I think everybody needs some money. We need to just give out some money to everybody, or some debit cards.
So give everybody a debit card.
Yes, if they worried about printing cash, they can do the credit, and when they do that, it'll help people get their lives together.
Well, I hope so too. We're on Shirley. We'll make sure we come back to the store and see you another time there. It's always good talking to you.
Likewise, take care, baby.
And good luck with that bakery business. I'm sure it's very popular.
Oh, yeah, you come on by, I'll hook you up with the special brownies.
Okay, well, thanks, Aunt Shirley. We appreciate it. Take care for now. Bye-bye. Get her off the screen. Hi, Aunt Shirley's still there. We have another Aunt Shirley. There we go. I was so concerned that, anyway, Producers, who do we have next coming up? I know there's just a couple more people I see back there. There must be somebody else. I could probably sing a song over. Oh! It's the famous celebrity chef, Lad Fierro. How are you?
I'm great, man. I'm taking it down to Dimmeryville.
I've heard you say that on the show. That's fantastic. What are you doing in Indianapolis?
Oh, I'm here for my restaurant.
What's the new one going to be called?
It's going to be called Pickled Beets.
Pickled Beets. That's seems a rather niche market for you, lad.
It is. We're going to have pickled beets with everything. We're going to have mashed turnips and fried durian.
Wow, durian. If people don't know what that is, please look it up on the internet. Lad, a question, if you don't mind. We're asking everybody today.
Absolutely.
If you were president, Lad, what one thing would you do to help the people of America?
I'd get everybody a hamburger.
Yes, you would. Well, thanks for coming down, Lad. We appreciate it as always. And make sure you go down to all Lad's 417 restaurants, right?
Bomb.com.
That's Lad Fierro, ladies and gentlemen. Not often we get a celebrity. Hey guys, do we have one more guest? I see one more. Hi. Hi.
Hola, mijito. No parece la clase para aprender manejar. Pagué mucho dinero para eso.
No. This is hi, we're on the TV show. My name is Justin Case.
Televisión? Mijito! Me llamo Ima Conchita Juanita Recino Celaya.
Can I call you Miss Juanita?
Sí, papi. Hace que le quiere.
I haven't been called papi in many years, but I'm a little flushed right now. It's obvious that you don't speak English, but you understand it really well. So that's really fantastic. What would you do, Miss Juanita, if you were president?
Presidente?
Sí, es un you presidente.
Parece que. ¿Qué es eso? Estaba presidente yo para quiero beber cerveza, quiero todo el gente del mundo tomar más cerveza.
I give everybody beer is what sí. This is. Oh, okay, good. Sí.
Es muy bien para los chiquitos y el grandes, viejitos, todos.
Everybody beer. Well, thank you. We appreciate you're new to the neighborhood, yes?
Sí, entiendo todo que está diciendo.
Oh, okay, well, we hope to come by again, if you don't mind, and interview you some other time when I understand.
¿Más televisión? Sí,
yes,
sí.
On televisión, yes. Au revoir, hasta la vista.
Adiós, mijito.
Adiós, mijito. I don't know what that means, but I guess I'm a mijito. Hey, gang, that's all the time we have for today. I hope you enjoyed your friends and neighbors in our community here answering the question of the day. Come back next Tuesday. New questions, new friends. I'm your host, Justin Case. Take care. Bye-bye. Cue the music.